Hi, good day everyone, and welcome to Close Attention YouTube channel once again. Today we want to quickly show you how to use MyUNISA, the MyUNISA portal, and then also how you can navigate in there, find your study materials, also look for your assignments, your study materials, all information. Like we're always saying, the most important study material in the study materials that you're gonna receive is TL101, which is tutorial letter 101. Now what do you do? Just come to Google Chrome, open it, then you type www.unisa.ac.za like this, and then you click the enter button, wait for it to open. Okay, it will show you a page like this with information about everything, registration and stuff. Now we don't wanna waste time talking about any other thing. We will quickly go to MyUNISA. As you can see on your right here, you click MyUNISA, wait for it to open. Then after that, what you're gonna be doing now is entering your login details once it open. Let us wait. Okay, we are waiting. We are having network problems because of load shedding. Now what do you do? Just come here, enter your username, a story number, and then the password. Okay, let us quickly do that. Okay, enter your story number and everything so that you click login, and boom, you are in. Now it will open like this. My modules, these are most important functions on your MyUNISA. Maybe you may find my modules 2023, like this year it is for 2021. Like you can find my modules 2023. When you find it, you click on it. If there is no my modules 2023, you just click my modules. Okay, now let us quickly first, before we go into my modules, let us come to the MyUNISA button here. Well, let us open my admin button. When you open it, it will give you lots of options. Let us wait for the system to open. Okay, now we're in. So here we're using a PC. If you're using a smartphone, it will be a different. There will be some three lines on the corner here where you can open menu, and then this student admin, study materials, student finance and assessment admin, together with teaching practice and any other options that will appear, they will be on the line from top to bottom. Okay, now let us check what's in student admin. After clicking my admin, now we just want to check what's in here on student admin. As you can see, you can request your academic record here, you can apply for exemption, you can there are biographical details, like you can change your addresses and stuff. Now all these other information, as you can see, if you are on final year student, you can request to exceed the max number of modules. All right, remember you are only allowed to register 10 modules, but if you are in your final year studies, you can register up to 12, because they, you want to complete, you can come and request here for the edition. Now readmission, this readmission button is for those who maybe studied in the past and then they skipped some years, now they want to come back and continue. Just come and log in, click readmission. Now register or edit your registration. If you want to add some modules or remove some, you just come and enter here. Request the cancellation. Oh, for cancellation you come here, it is when you are adding. Then I request proof of registration. If you want to use the proof of registration, that's here. You come, request semester change, everything is here under student admin. Now we go to study material. Let's see, on under study materials, that is when you can track your parcel, or you can track your parcel or your study material. Okay, let us quickly log in and see what's in here under study material. Now, as you can see, there is information here about the colleges. Here, College of Education, Accounting, blah blah blah. You're gonna get your study materials via DSV. Now, all these other colleges, Colleges of Science, Engineering, Human Sciences, College of Agric, blah blah, you're gonna get it via Madiwana SA. Now, let us check here first under DSV. What happens when you click on the link? Yes, to see if everything is still working. Hold on. I think having a network issue. Let us try to reload the page again and see what will happen. Okay, seems like this link is no longer working. So let us quickly go back. Let us quickly go back and continue. Okay, now we are still under my admin. Remember, yes, when you track if it will be working, you just click on the link, it will open and give you where you can enter the registration ID or parcel ID. Then you click your student number. That's simple. Then you search. Okay, let us skip here. It was under a study material. Now go to student finance. Here is where you see your financial details. When you open here and study fee quotation, if you want to make quotation and see how much you're supposed to pay, everything is here. Then now assessment. Here you can submit some of the assignments. Okay, let us log in. You can view examination timetable, you can view examination results, assignments. When you click assignment submission button, because you're gonna be using this function also to view some of to submit some of the assessment, it will open like this. Let us wait and wait. Okay, now we are in. It will open like this. What do you do? The list of modules will be appearing here like this. Now what you only have to do is look at the assignment number. As you can see, there's 1, 2, 3 going down. If it is assignment number 1, you just come here and click here. There will be a button to which is written submit somewhere here. Then you click submit. That's all. Then you submit. Then when you get your marks, it will be like this here. Then you just view and view. That's all. Now let us quickly go back now to my admin again, closing this button. Now I think we are done. This one is for those who are doing teaching or Bachelor of Education. Now if you want to enter the school details here where you're going to be doing your observations and practicals, you just come here and click student placement. Okay, now it's password management. You can come and change your password here. All right, now what do we do? We are done with my admin. Now we go to my modules. Okay, let us click my modules. Remember, on my modules you can click my modules or my modules 2023. Okay, now let us wait. We are in under my modules. Now here you can come and open the list of the modules that you have registered for here. When you open here, all the list will be appearing here, right? Okay, now another thing, you can come to the dashboard here and then you click, let us click on the dashboard. Okay, so let us click here under my modules. All right, after clicking under my modules, let us just quickly choose any module. We can come and choose, for example, let's just choose this one. Before we choose, the list of the modules that will be appearing here, there are some students who don't know how they can identify a year module and a semester module. If you can see, there is a Y here, Y here, Y here. This just indicates that this is a year module. It's a year module. If it's it was a semester module, there was gonna be S here. There was gonna be an S. So because it's Y, it's a year module. Now let us open this module. When it open, you get this welcome message. This is not important. You can read it. Now let us quickly come to the left here. Under dashboard, my courses, and then the name of the module will be here, the module code. Now let us look, but yes, some of the things are not important here. Grades are the results that you have received for the assessments that you have submitted. Now let us quickly skip all this. You can come and read the frequently asked questions. prescribed materials. Under prescribed materials, it is when you will be shown which study materials you are required to have in order to be able to cope with this module and complete assessments as well as the examination. Now, the name of the study material, prescribed material, here is a discovering geometry, blah blah. This is the title, the author. Then when you go and look for this, whether you're looking for it as a PDF in Telegram groups or in a bookstore, you're gonna be verifying these details here. Publication, year of publication, publisher name, edition, book notes, everything. Okay, now let us quickly go back again. How do we go back? Let us click the back button now. Other prescribed material. Now we're going back to check for other options. Are they just taking time to open because of network? Let us quickly see something here. Okay, we're still in. Let us wait for it to open now. Or you can quickly, another way beside clicking the back button here, you can come here and click go to course. Still the same thing. Now let us wait for it to open. It's taking time. Okay, I think it's opening. Now we've got network problem. As you can see, now we are connected again. I will click reload so that we can go back to this module. Okay, this is the welcome message we're talking about. Let us click dashboard. We open dashboard. Prescribed material, now we are passing it. Official study material and prescribed materials, not the same thing. Prescribed materials, the materials that you need to have. Additional ones that you need to buy, sometimes you will be required to buy this. Official study materials are study materials that you are given to by the lecturer, like tutorial letters. The official study materials are consisting of information on how you can write your assignments, where to get assignment questions and stuff. Now official study material, you open like this, you will see there is a tutorial letter 102, tutorial letter 101, the most important one is this one, tutorial letter 101. Now this one is a study guide, 001 is a study guide. You will see GD001 for your module here. Now let us open tutorial letter 101. Now we quickly go download tutorial letter 101. Let us open and see what's in here. When I see if there are some assignments in there or not. It's taking time to open. Let me check. Okay, remember guys, please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel so that we can be able to provide you with online classes and assist you with assignments. And also don't forget to follow our Facebook page, which is Close Attention. Okay, now we are waiting for tutorial letter 101 to open because we are downloading it. Okay, remember we downloaded it and I'm here. Now we are waiting for it to open. Now this is the tutorial letter. TL101 is the tutorial letter, which is consisting of all the important information. Like tutorial letter 101 is like your lecturer. It gives you everything you need in order to complete everything under the module that you will be doing. Now the first page is just showing you. Let us quickly go to the most important part. Okay, just go like this. Number two, we would like to go to number four, introduction and everything. You read this yourself, and curriculum information, yes, lecturers details, everything is here. You just come and look for the details. When you have a query, you want to ask something about the model, then you come under lecturer details and contact details here. Check the email, use your My Life email to send the lecturer a query and ask him whatever you'll be asking, or you take your phone and call the number depending on the model that you'll be doing. Now let us skip here and go to this to see what resources. Under resources, that is when you will be able to know whether your model have got a prescribed book. You cannot do a model without the prescribed book. Okay, for this one is yes, Sarah, Michael, 2008, discovering geometry, blah blah. We have seen this under official study material, under prescribed material, right? Now you come here and look for the books that you're supposed to have. That is why I'm saying this TR101 is the most important one. Come in to check for the books that you would like to have in order to complete the model. Now the second part is under resources is recommended books. Recommended books are the also books that you need in order to complete the model, but they are not equally important as prescribed books. This is just additional sources that can assist you in having it easy to complete the model that you'll be doing right now. Also, the third part is electronic reserves or e-reserves. Like here is online study material, like soft copies. You can get it on UNISA. When you follow this link, everything will be easy. Just by reading the screen, the details of the source or study material is written here. Now let us skip and go to the assessment part. I think the assessment part is the most important one. Student support services, everything you will read it yourselves. Now the study plan, as you can see, study plan, every tutorial letter will be having this section. They are trying to show you the way or the pace so that you can be able to set your pace. See, from January to February, you will have to familiarize yourself with the blah blah blah. From this month to this one, you do this from blah 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 and do the assessment. You also read here on your own. Let us skip. We have made this video because lots of students are struggling to use MyUNISA. They can't even see the assignments. So we'd like to show you how you can be able to view your assignments. Now this is the most important section, assessment. Assessment criteria, you read here. Now we wanna look for assessments. Assessment plan. Assessment plan, they're letting you know about the required assessments, which are four. So it's different according to the model you'll be doing. Now let us, yes, they are telling you how much the assessments weighed. Like here's 20%, 20% plus blah blah blah. Let us skip. Now assignment numbers. Assignment numbers. This one you can see it under assignments. Like I have shown you when I went to the I was submitting assessments under assessment submissions. You will see it. Assignment due dates and everything also is on MyUNISA. Submission of assignments, everything you read here. Because here we didn't come across any assignment, it means that assignments are online on MyUNISA. Okay, those who are struggling to find assessments, some of you may be lucky and find that all your assessments are included under this tutorial letter 101. Now because here on this one there is no assignment, we close it. Let us close it and go to online again. Remember, we were still under official study material. Now we go to the course. Like I said, you can click go to the course so that you can be able to view this thing. Okay, let us just go to this course again. We're going to dashboard this side so that we can remember we're still under study material. Now we want to look for assignments. Where do we find these assignments? Where do we find the assignments? Now Under dashboard, you have this. We were here, official study material. Now we wanna pass. Now where do we go? Now we go to this study guide and scribe book. These ones are lucky enough because now they've been given the PDF book here and the study guide. Okay, this travel letter. You see now, when you're scrolling down under dashboard here on this module, you will see your assessments. Here are the assignments. Remember, they are not on tutorial letter 101, so they are online. They're here. Come to the assessment one, you open for it and see what's in. As you can see, this one is a quiz. Most of you will be writing a quiz or multiple choice assessments, so you only do them online. As you can see here, there will be the writing attempts allowed is 2. They mean that you can open this and submit twice. Like when you log in and not submit, it's not counted as an attempt, right? An attempt is after you submit, because if you log in and not submit, you will just come back and click, there will be somewhere here written a resume, then you resume and complete and submit. But if you submit here, when you come back, it will say attempts allowed 1, because already you have used the first attempt of submitting. Maybe you submitted and you were not satisfied with the way you answered your assessment. Now everything will be here, closing date, everything will be on the corner right here. Now what do we do? You come here and do everything, answer the quiz. Before you open this one, the quiz one, online one, you must make sure that you go through study material and you are ready. Okay, now let us quickly go and check for assessment number 2. You go to assessment number 2 if there is assessment number 2. And then this one is not an online one. This is the most important one that we want to show you how to you do it. This assessment number 2, when you open it, it will be like this. This one you submit online. You download the question paper. The question paper now is no longer here because this is not for the 2023. Now question paper will be somewhere here at the top, or written in yellow like color, like this one. You just come here and click on it and download it. It will be consisting of your questions and how you should complete the assignment. Also, some of the assignments, they will show you where to go and study in your study guides and your prescribed book, so that you can be able to answer the assessment. Now after answering the assessment, you come straight here and you click assessment 2 like we did. If you want to submit, there will be a submission button here at the bottom. You just come here and click submit. There will be a submit button. You click submit and then you click an option for you to upload a document will be shown. Then you click document upload, then you submit here. If you are taking time to submit your assessment, it will show here that how many days are left for you to submit the assessment. Okay, everything you can check here. Now let us quickly come and open some assessment number 4, maybe see what's in here. Okay, just like that one, it's not an online one, everything up here. Now you can submit here if it's a document where you are supposed to submit. Remember, every assignment must be submitted as a PDF. Now what do you do if you don't want to submit here? Sometimes you will be allowed to submit here under my admin. We are done with my module, I think. Okay, before we go there, I think there is something that we should look at under my modules again. Let us go to under my modules and quickly check for something. Quickly. We're almost there. Now under my modules, unfortunately we don't have where we can show a group here. We will be able to complete the discussion and everything. Okay, now we have opened this module. Let us see if there will be an option for groups and everything. For discussion and stuff, the option will appear here. Then you can open the discussion and continue. So simple, it's a simple thing. I think we've covered everything. You'll be able to navigate here because I will just read what's written here. Also, the announcement is very much important to open announcement and check out everything. Now, you don't want to submit at the way we're submitting. You want to submit under my admin. Just come and do the very same thing we said. Let us wait for it to open. Let me quickly confirm if we still have internet connection. We still do. Now we wait for it to open. Guys, remember we are still assisting with assessments. We are still assisting with assessments. Now here is a discussion. Under announcement, the discussion. Some of you will be required to join the discussion groups and everything. Then just come here and see for yourself what you can do. Then you open the topic, you'll be able to comment. Now we cannot open to see the other people's conversations here. Now we just go to my admin where you wanna submit. You come under my admin. Remember we said assessment admin. I think we are done here. Assessment submission, assignment submission. Then you come quickly and click the login details, login, and then you are in. You come here and submit everything here. Just look for the model here. You come and click submit button somewhere here, and then you choose the file where you have saved it and upload. Just make sure that your files are in PDF. Thank you guys for watching. I think we have tried to cover everything here. There is nothing that we didn't cover. Everything is sorted. Now I think we've covered everything. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe. We're gonna be sharing some of the lessons, online classes, on our YouTube channel in a few days time. Please support us by subscribing so that we can also be able to assist you. Please assist us to assist you. Okay, thank you guys. My name is Matambele Tembuluo. Thank you for watching, and let's meet in the next video. Thank you, bye.